Instagram story ads present one of the biggest opportunities for advertisers online. Today I'm going to show you exactly how to analyze the data so you know whether or not they're working. Chances are you're familiar with Facebook ads, and you might even be familiar with the data that goes with them. But Instagram is really different, and when you look at stories, those are kind of like an ad placement within a platform that's totally different than anything else is running. Understanding how to do them well is what's gonna separate you from the competition, but knowing how to do them well requires that you understand how to look at your data. If you're someone that uses Instagram stories, you may be surprised to find when you run story ads, you don't have access to the same statistics you do when they're run organically. Everything shows up through Ads Manager, and it's missing some of the key things you might really be used to seeing. You may also be wondering, well, there's a Facebook Ads app. Can I use that? Technically, yes, you can see some of the ads data in there, but if you really want to have maximum geekage when it comes to looking at your data, you're going to want to do it on a desktop. There are a lot of numbers in Ads Manager, most of which probably aren't going to apply to you. However, I'm going to show you the ones that actually matter when you're looking at story ads. Be sure to stick around to the end of this video. I am going to give you the answer to the most asked question about Instagram story ads I always get. So when you go in, it's going to have a default view. This is probably not the one you're gonna wanna use. If you head over to the right, you're gonna see this section called Columns. If you click on it, there are pre-made reports that you can look at. Now, some of these overlap with each other. If you choose engagement, and then you look at something like video engagement, you might see some of the same columns. These are really just pre-made views to make things easier so you're not having to choose things. I'm gonna show you the ones that are gonna be most useful, but I wanna make a note about this account in particular. You're gonna see a lot of large numbers here. It's okay if your account is not this big, and frankly, it's probably not typical for what most agencies are looking at. I picked this one for a very important reason though. We have spent millions of dollars in story ads, and the patterns we see are the same ones that apply to small accounts. The issue is, when an account is small, there's not a lot of data, so it can be hard to see these patterns. Assuming that you're running your story ads bundled together with other placements, all of that just shows up as the single line item, which isn't really gonna help you if you wanna know how your story ads are doing. Luckily, you can look at them separately. If you go all the way over to the right, you see this dropdown called Breakdown. Clicking on that gives you a whole bunch of different ways that you can segment this data to see how certain pockets of it are performing. If you scroll down, you're gonna see there's one for placement. When you click on that, it's gonna take anything you are running and it's gonna show you what's making up all those totals that you see. Every single Facebook line item you have, every single Instagram line item you have, including stories, is gonna show up here. If you see stories not showing up, it could be either because you chose not to run there or, and this is one of the challenge of Instagram stories, there's not a ton of inventory there. Sometimes when Facebook is auto-optimizing, it's just gonna opt out of stories because it doesn't feel sure about whether you're gonna perform there. Those are instances where you may wanna consider running stories separately if you're trying to get more data, because sometimes Facebook just isn't gonna favor you for that placement. What we're looking at right now is video engagement. Here's one for Instagram stories. We know that it's gotten 45,827 impressions, so we have some idea of what is it costing us to get a 10-second view, 19 cents. How many people are watching all the way through? 1,000 people. How much is it costing us for them to watch all the way through? 25 cents. These are stats that kind of help you understand where your money is going if you're not looking at conversions. If you're running a video in a whole bunch of different places, you can say, I know that on Facebook's desktop newsfeed, it's costing me 66 cents for someone to watch all the way through, but on Instagram stories, it's only costing 25 cents. When you're thinking about building remarketing audiences, these are the costs you want to keep in mind. And if you're wondering about how to use these costs and build remarketing audiences with them, make sure you check out our video on building effective funnels. This is where these costs become really important because understanding how far you're going to take your budget depending on your objective is how you're going to win. Now, because there are so many numbers, it might be tempting to think, wow, all of these matter. The truth of the matter is they really don't. If we're looking at our Instagram story and we know that they last for 15 seconds, do we really care how much it's costing for someone to watch 3 seconds? If you see that it's costing you $5 for a 10-second view, and all the rest of these channels are only at like 8 cents or $2 at the most, that's a good indicator that people are not watching to the 10-second mark, and something might be wrong. There's things like that that are important to remember in feeds versus stories, so make sure you also watch our video about the differences in those things so you kind of know what you're looking for. When it comes to stories, you'd want to view it relative to what are the other placements doing and what does that cost, and then what is it you're looking for it to do. If your objective is to get people to watch or interact with your Instagram story ad and not necessarily to buy, I don't want to evaluate this based on what it sold because that's not its job. So in this case, this is a top of funnel audience that I'm running this to. So I really care about how much it's costing me just to get them to notice the brand. And in this case, it's about 19 cents. If you want to get really crazy, there is this section for customized columns. And when you click on that, you're going to have access to a whole bunch of other data that you can add or take away depending on what it is you care about. It's a little overwhelming, I won't lie. Might not be where you want to start if you're new at this, but just know that it's there. So if you want to explore some of the other options as far as analysis goes, they are in there. Let's say that you're running Instagram story ads and the goal is conversion. You're going to want to look at different things. So if you go to your pre-made columns, there is a version for performance and clicks. If you click on that, the data is going to look very different. Now you're looking at things like what are the results based on what the goal of that ad set was. So in this case, this was going for purchases. Of the purchase conversion events, here's how many happened. Here's the frequency at which these people saw the ad in the amount of time that we've chosen. Here's how much it cost to get that purchase. Here was the budget, et cetera, et cetera. If you scroll over, you'll start to see things like what was the cost per click? How many purchases did these specific line items drive? So when you look at something like Instagram stories, this is where things can start to get interesting for your brand. Let's say we look at something like cost per click. In this instance, we paid $1.27 for someone to click through to our site. That's actually pretty cheap when you look at some of the other placements here. But if you start to scroll through and look at things like how many purchases happened, how much did that purchase cost you? What was your return on spend? All of those things are really important to look at because it's going to start to help you understand how are my story ads performing relative to some of these other placements. All of those things are things you want to keep in mind when you look at it. So as promised, one of the biggest questions I get when people set up their accounts is, should I just set up stories in its own ad set and run it separately from the Instagram feed, or should I put them together? When you're first launching, you're probably gonna want to run them together. Just kind of need to get a place to start. You need to know, how often is Facebook showing it? Does it seem like the creative's not even doing well? So before you allocate a whole bunch of budget to something that might be inefficient, start to just get a feel for whether it's doing great or whether it's doing poorly. If it's doing really well, you're gonna wanna maximize the budget. Facebook really isn't that great about making sure you show up on Instagram story ads a lot. They'll show you a fair amount, but a lot of times they just favor the feed because there's more data to go on. You're probably gonna have to combat that by saying, I only wanna run in stories in this ad set, and then just putting a whole bunch of budget towards it. If it's not doing well, that's an indicator you probably need to work on your creative a little bit, and you may not wanna do that outside in a separate ad set. You may just wanna keep trying to hone it while it's still bundled with other stuff so you maintain some kind of efficiency with your budget. If, however, your experience is the former where you're like, I see some promise here. Here's a great example of what can happen when you break those things out separately. Here we have an interest campaign that was based on Instagram feed and then one that is running only on stories. These two were not always separated like this. They used to be bundled together. And then over time, we saw Instagram was doing better, but we weren't maximizing budget. We saw that stories started to pull ahead and we weren't really able to maximize budget there. So it can also be this iterative process where maybe you bundle everything together first. It doesn't have to be something that just gets decided once. You may decide to do it later. And in this case, you can see what happens when it works really well. Story ads obviously have a much cheaper cost than the feed does. So the feed, we're paying $15.20 for every 1,000 ad impressions. And stories, we're paying a third of that. There's less competition and it's way cheaper. Doesn't necessarily mean anything if it's not selling, but it's just an interesting point to note because we still see that this is the case even today. Then we move over to something like click-through rate and cost per click. The Instagram feed is at $3.89. at a 0.39% click-through rate. Stories is at $1.27 at a 0.46 rate. Stories is still doing better. Not surprisingly, when you look at the number or quantity of website purchases, they're higher for the Instagram feed. Makes sense because there's a lot more ads on the feed than there are on stories. They just have more opportunity to sell that much. If you look at the return on spend, for this brand, they're getting a 24.5% return on spend for feed. If you go out of stories, they're getting a 31, almost 32 return on spend. That is an enormous return on spend. Again, it's not necessarily normal. As you get these spends at scale, these are the type of patterns we see. When you take the time to make your stories work and you start to see them do well and you maximize your budget, no matter how big or small that budget is, there are many times where we will see stories absolutely outperform the feed. Those are the cases where we strongly recommend that you do break them out into their own placement because that's the only way you're gonna get all the inventory that story ads have out there. Knowing when it's time to break this out is kind of a judgment call. You really need to look at how Stories is doing relative to the other placements it's bundled in, kind of like I showed you earlier. If it's doing well when it's bundled with other stuff, odds are it's gonna do very well when it's on its own and it has its own budget and you can test creative a lot more. You're gonna find that you can get it to do even better. So if it's showing promise relative to everything else when it's bundled together, it's a safe bet that it's gonna do really well when you break it out on its own. As you can see from the data, ads are a really important part of your social strategy. Click the playlist on your screen right now for all of our tips and tricks on how to use Instagram to grow your business.